Welcome friends. This session, we are going to study about syllogism in logic. Introduction. The syllogism is defined as a deductive argument in which a conclusion is inferred from two premises. It is immediate inference by which we arrive at conclusion from two given propositions called premises. The propositions that compose a syllogism may be categorical, hypothetical, or disjunctive. Accordingly, a syllogism may be pure or mixed. Pure syllogism consists of propositions of same kind, whereas mixed consists of propositions of different kinds. Pure syllogisms are of three: categorical, hypothetical, disjunctive. Mixed syllogism are again divided into three: hypothetical categorical, disjunctive categorical, and dilemma. Categorical syllogism. A categorical syllogism is defined as a form of argument consisting of three categorical propositions which contains three and only three terms. Two of them are premises and the third is the conclusion. It is a deductive argument in which two propositions are given and infer the third one. The conclusion of a syllogism is a categorical proposition that contains two of the syllogism's three terms. The conclusion is always used to identify the terms of the syllogism. The term that occurs as the predicate of the conclusion is the major term. The term that occurs as the subject of the conclusion is the minor term. The term that does not occur in the conclusion but contains in both the premises is the middle term. Example: all Russians were revolutionists. All anarchists were revolutionists. Therefore, all anarchists were Russians. Here, anarchist is the minor term, Russians is the major term, and the middle term is the revolutionist. This is the standard form of a categorical syllogism. In a standard form categorical syllogism, the major premise is stated first, minor will be the second, and conclusion last. Figure of a syllogism. The figure of a syllogism is that which indicates the position of the middle term in the premises. As there are two premises in a syllogism, and as the middle term occurs in both, there are four possible ways of arranging the terms in an argument. The middle term may be the subject term of the major premise and the predicate term of the minor premise, or it may be the predicate term of both premises, or it also be the subject term of both the premises. It may also be the predicate term of the major premise and the subject term of the minor premise. These different possible positions of the middle term constitute the first, second, third, and fourth figure respectively. Figure 1, M, P, S, M, therefore, S, P. Figure 2, P, M, S, M, therefore, S, P. Figure 3, M, P, M, S, therefore, S, P. Figure 4, P, M, M, S, S, P. Mode of a syllogism. The mode of a syllogism is determined by the quantity and quality of the constituent propositions of the syllogisms. Syllogisms vary in respect of the quantity and quality of the propositions which constitute them. This character of the propositions which go to form a syllogism is called the mode of the syllogism. For instance, if all the three propositions of a syllogism are universal affirmative, then the mode of that syllogism is AAA. Example: all Indians are Asians, all Gujaratis are Indians, therefore, all Gujaratis are Asians. The validity of a syllogism depends